first official record of the church here at Tal-y-Llyn is 1254, but it was probably a simple wooden one. The present building is about 500 years old. It's the late 15th century, 1470, something like that. Very typical example of a small Welsh church. The population of the area was probably much larger than it is now. This is in the early 1800s. Many of the small holdings and cottages have fallen into ruin as people have moved away to the town. The arrangement of the lych gates is unusual. One to the south of the churchyard served the people of Corris, who came along the mountainside because the lake frequently flooded the road, which is much lower than it is today. The north lych gate served the Abergynolwyn side of the parish. The roof timbers of the church are fixed with wooden pegs, no nails were used. It is said that at one time the church was thatched with moss and straw, and that parishioners undertook this work. The bell bears the date 1583. The bell rope was in the little cupboard at the end there. The arch or testa with the painted rose is a striking feature of the church. It was probably the work of a 15th century artist when the present church was built. The decoration was a popular form at the end of the Wars of the Roses. I thought it was something to do with that, because there's red and white roses there. Late 15th century. And there are other details common to medieval art. At one time, small decorative bosses embellished the intersections between the main panels. The early feature of the church, now long gone, was the rood screen, fixed to the crossbeam of the roof nearest the altar. Slats in the beam can still be seen. There was once a gallery loft at the back of the church. On demolition, the date 1765 was found on one of the post sockets supporting the loft. Presumably this was the date of its erection. It can be seen that the end crossbeam of the church has been cut away and replaced with a light strut. Yes, I can see it. On which hung a lantern. The old beam interfered with the view of the altar for the people who were in the gallery. They adopted the simple but drastic solution of sawing it off. And the church was altered and restored in 1876, gallery removed, and the timber being used to partition off the south transept, which is now the vestry, which is where the door is in there. And the floor was lowered. Many loads of earth were removed from the interior of the church, including coffin plates and human bones. And these were reburied in the churchyard. The pulpit and reading desk were installed, as was the stained glass window. Note the small Welsh dragon depicted on the inn sign in the parable of the Good Samaritan. Someone had a sense of humour.